This video, I'm going to show you how to cut an internal thread. So for this particular part, if you see the threads are shown right there, it's an 832 UNC, and the threaded part is 3/8 of an inch deep. So that's what we're looking for. In order to do that, we do need to know the size of the tap drill. So if you look up a tap drill chart, you can look up these online. They're really easy to find. So it's a tap drill chart for standard threads. Go down to an 832 and you'll see it's a number 29 drill, so there's your tap drill, or it's a 0.136. That would be a cut tap, and here's the rolled tap. It's 0.1495 or 0.15, so somewhere between 0.14 and 0.15, so that would be our tap drill size. So the tap drill is always going to be smaller, because remember, you're going to go in there with a tap and cut out material. So there's a couple of different ways you can do it. One way is you can just use the hole wizard. So let's just use the hole wizard. It's a straight tap. It's ANSI inch, a bottoming tap, because it doesn't go all the way through. The size is 832. And then you want to show the depth of it. The depth is actually going to be, let's see, that's the hole itself. Here's the threaded part. It's 0.375. You always drill a little bit deeper than you're going to cut the threads. And then come over here and click on position, and it says select the face. So we'll select that face right there, and then it's going to ask you to really position it. So if you come out to the outside, don't click it, and you'll see the center will be highlighted. If you come in here and click that, that'll make it concentric. And then say OK. And that's going to show a simplified representation for a thread. Remember back in CAD 1, we talked about that too. So there will be that represents your thread, which is totally fine. That's one way to do it. The thing about that is it takes up a lot less memory to show it that way. Let me show you another method for doing that. And that would be, first thing you're going to do is put a hole in it. So use that tap drill size, which was 0.136, and just do a sketch and cut a hole in there, and then go to your hole wizard and just click on thread. Instead of hole wizard, click on thread. Since I already have the hole, all we have to do is add the thread. Let's see, check our settings. It's going to be 3/8 deep. It's an inch tap. Remember, an internal hole is going to be cut with, internal thread will be cut with a tap. It's 832. Everything's fine. So now just click on that circle right there. And what it's going to do is going to show you the more complete representation of the thread. So now it actually looks like a thread. So it depends on what you're going for. One thing to be aware of, that uses a lot more memory on your computer. So you have a bunch of threaded holes. I would use that hole wizard method. But either way, that's how you're going to show your thread. And then when you're done, you put it on your drawing sheet, you're going to actually show the thread. If you use the simplified one, you won't see that, those kind of lines. You'll just see the double set of hidden lines. And the call out you're going to put on there is, don't call out the drilled hole. You call out the thread size. So the way to do that is just use your diameter tool. Put a leader on there, and then just take that dimension and edit it to say what you want it to say. If it calls out the diameter, just delete that and type in the thread size. Remember, what we need to know is the thread size. The people manufacturing it will look up the tap drill size. You don't need to tell them that. Obviously, you also locate where it is, but in terms of the threaded hole, that's how you're going to do that.